thanks for inviting us in tonight. We've got a lot to get to, but we want to start with some positive news. COVID cases, hospitalizations, and deaths all trending downward here in Indiana. This is something we've been waiting to see for months. But what's causing it? And between the vaccine and the new versions of the virus, what's on the horizon? We want to start tonight's big story with input from the experts.
Well, with the year that we've had, it's almost one of those things you're afraid to say out loud because you don't want to jinx it. But as of late, Indiana's COVID numbers have been looking pretty good.
This chart is encouraging, a continued downward move of COVID cases in Indiana over the past several weeks, under 3,000 each day since January 22nd, and the 1,565 reported cases Tuesday, the lowest since October. Good news, but even researchers say there's not a good answer as to why.
I think that it's baffling a lot of scientists as to why the disease has sort of, if you will, kind of flown south for the winter.
Brian Dixon is the director of public health informatics at the Regenstrief Institute. And while nearly 600,000 Hoosiers have been given at least one shot of the vaccine, he says that's not enough to solely explain the decrease.
Given that our vaccine rollout was slower than we anticipated, so it really only picked up within the last couple of weeks. So I don't think the vaccine is something we can really point to as the definitive cause for this decline.
But less cases is also leading to less patients at hospitals. Dr. Graham Carlos at Eskenazi believes the decrease is not just one factor.
Number one, a lot of people have had COVID, so they have some immunity. Number two, vaccinations. Hoosiers are doing a great job getting vaccines. That's creating some immunity within the community. And then lastly, people are still wearing masks. They are distancing. They are taking this virus seriously. All of those things combined are helping us out.
Of course, still people cannot relax, especially with these new virus variations.
We don't know what type of immunity they'll have against these new variants. You've heard about the South African one in particular.
And also that we continue to push to vaccinate the population as quickly as possible, because it's possible for a third wave to appear sometime in the spring or potentially in early summer.
We hope to see our cases and hospitalizations continue to go down as the vaccine rollout continues to ramp up. Right now, you do have to be 65 and up, a healthcare worker, or at a long-term care facility to qualify for the shot here in Indiana. The simple reason? The state says these are the highest-risk Hoosiers, and there just are not enough shots for everyone to receive one right now. So far, however, almost 600,000 Hoosiers have at least one dose of the vaccine in their system. That accounts for nearly 9% of the 6.8 million people in the state of Indiana. As you can see, compared to the rest of the country, that's about the average. But the Biden administration now is ramping things up. So here are the three things you need to know. Number one, 1 million doses are going to start shipping to pharmacies next week. They're going to arrive at 6,500 locations all across the country, taking appointments and administering the shots. However, they still follow state guidelines, meaning if you're not eligible, you can't just sign up and get a shot.
Sign-ups at pharmacies are still expected to go through our state's website, ourshot.in.gov. That's where you can find similar appointments at clinics and stores like Walmart, Meijer, and Kroger. We're hoping to get more details from state health leaders tomorrow about which pharmacy locations will offer the vaccine and how soon. Remember, if you have any questions about how to get the vaccine or if you're eligible, text the word vaccine to the number you see here on your screen. We'll send resources straight to your phone. And that wraps up tonight's big story.